The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love. Just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in His love. I have told you this so that my own joy may be in you and your joy be complete." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, I begin with the last verse. I have told you this so that my own joy may be in you and your joy be complete. The Lord wants us to have true joy, lasting joy. That is the reason you have come this evening to this place of grace. To have joy, complete joy, joy in the Lord. During the Christmas season, I used to say the meaning of this joy. J means Jesus, first J, O means others, then Y is you. Give primacy to God, second place to others, then think of yourself, that is true joy. Today Jesus tells us, we have to remain in His love. He says that He remains in the love of the Father by keeping His commandments. And Jesus asks us to keep His commandment and thus remain in His love. Whoever does not keep the Ten Commandments, whoever does not understand the summary of these Ten Commandments, giving primacy to God and loving one another as we love ourselves and a bit more as Jesus loved us, doesn't remain in the love of Jesus, cannot have true joy. Sometimes people think that they can have joy when they do what they want. It is not true. Jesus says, I am telling you this, to remain in my love, that to remain in my love by keeping my commandments, then you will have joy. The words of Jesus cannot be untrue, cannot be false. Let us try, my dear brothers and sisters, every day to give primacy to God and to follow the commandment of love, fraternal charity that Jesus asks of us. That takes me also to the first reading today. It is the continuation of yesterday's deliberation. The first council of Jerusalem met. Some of them wanted to impose on others their own ideas, their own rules and regulations. The disciples deliberated for a long time under the leadership of the elder pastors of the church, under the leadership of Peter. In other words, they said, pagans, in their context, the non-Jews must be circumcised. Only then they can be saved. It is not enough if they believe in Christ. It is not enough if they are baptized. Paul and Barnabas said, we experience the power of the Lord in the pagans, in the non-Jews. Why don't you be open, Paul told them. They are not wanting to listen. Finally, Peter says boldly, do not impose your ideas on people when God is generous to accept the pagans. Real love manifested in the first meeting by the words of Peter. They can be asked to do certain things. Don't make your opinions to become the burdens of other people. Sometimes we say, this is the way to do, that is the way to do. Little things, unnecessary things. What is most important is our faith, is our fraternal charity. Respect the freedom of the individuals. Don't be more strict than God Himself. God is generous. Do not impose your ideas on others. Finally, Jesus says, don't demand too much of them. They believe, they receive the Holy Spirit, they get the baptism, sufficient. But orderly living, we may prescribe certain things. Don't think that is necessary for salvation. Some of us are very clever in imposing our view of things on others in each and everything. The Ten Commandments cannot be compromised with. But there are so many other things in which we ought to be open, generous, understanding. Manifestation of our fraternal charity. May we have this heart of God in giving people the necessary freedom, in understanding others as long as they trust in Jesus and practice fraternal charity every day. Amen.